calls her Juliet, and likewise she for him. Beauty is a vice that draws them together. But their families are sworn enemies. So there's a darkness that hangs over them. So there's no dates over gumbo and beignets, no holding hands, no walks in the park. The precious daughter, Juliet, is watched like a hawk. And the danger makes the desire more intense, sweetening the stolen moments with pleasure. Psst, Romeo. Sam cried out. Can it be?
But soft. The light the yonder window breaks. It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Oh, rise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon. Oh, it is my lady. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. See how she leans her cheek upon her hand. Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I may touch that cheek.
Romeo. Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or if thou will not, be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet. Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not called, retain that dear perfection to which he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name, and for that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word. Call me but love, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth, I will never be Romeo.
Art thou not Romeo and a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if either thee dislike.
How camest thou hither and tell me wherefore? This place is death, considering who thou art, if my kinsmen find thee here.
Alack, there lies more peril in thine eyes than 20 of their swords.
Up enough for the world, they saw thee here. Thou knowst the mask of night is on my face, else would a maiden blush to paint my cheek for that which thou hast heard me speak tonight. Gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully. Or if thou thinkst I am too quickly won, I'll frown and be perverse and say thee nay, so that thou wilt woo. But else, not for the world. In truth, fair Montague, I am too fond. But trust me, gentlemen, I'll prove more true than those that have more cunning to be strange.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon,
I vow. By the moon, the inconstant moon, lest that thy love likewise prove variable.
What shall I swear by?
Do not swear. Although I joy in thee, I have no joy in this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden. Too like the lightning which doth cease to be ere one could say in Latins. Sweet good night.
But wilt thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
The exchange of thy love, faithful vow, for mine.
I gave thee mine before thou didst request it, and yet I would it were to give again.
Wouldst thou withdraw it? For what purpose, love?
Frank, he giveth thee again. And yet I wish, before the thing I have, my bounty is as boundless as the sea, my love as deep. The more I give to thee, the more I have, for both are infinite.
Madam!
I hear some noise within. Three words, dear Romeo, and good night indeed. If that thy bent of love be honorable, thy purpose marriage, send me word tomorrow by one that I'll procure to come to thee. Where and what time thou wilt perform the rite. And all my fortunes at thy foot I lay, and follow thee, my lord, throughout the world.
Madam!
I come anon! But if thou mean'st not well, I do beseech thee.
Madam!
By and by I come! To cease thy suit and lead me to my grief.
So thrive my soul.
Good night. Good night.
sleep dwell upon thine eyes, a peace in thy breast. Would I were to sleep in peace, so sweet to rest. Hence why to my spiritual father, his help to crave and my dear have to tell.
And you got me let go. What you want from